3.6E. I am learning to explore different forms of energy, including mechanical, light, sound, and thermal energy in everyday life.
Duh!
That food smirk!
We are going to be exploring different forms of energy. The forms of energy include mechanical,
light energy,
sound, and thermal energy. Also known as heat.
What is mechanical energy and how do we use it?
Mechanical energy is the energy of moving objects. I rely on mechanical energy when I'm mountain biking to be able to power myself up the hills, but I also rely on mechanical energy to control my descent as I go back down the hills. Sound is energy that travels through the air in waves.
Sound travels much the same way that it does in my Slinky.
Notice how the sound waves are projected forward, but as soon as they hit that barrier, they bounced back and came back towards me. And then as soon as it got to me, again, it rebounded off of me and bounced back again. It's an invisible energy that has very physical effects. So once a noise is produced, it can echo and bounce and rebound off of anything that it hits, but you'll never be able to see it. You can definitely feel sound energy though. So the way we use sound energy in our everyday lives, I think, is a little bit obvious, right? It's every single sound that we hear. Everything that we can hear is sound energy. Me personally, my favorite use of sound energy is right here. And how does my instrument, my guitar, make sound energy? Well, what happens is when I play one of those chords, the sound energy travels into the hole and bounces all around inside the wooden body of my guitar. And then eventually, after it bounces around and collects more and more sound, eventually what we hear is what escapes back out of this hole. So as the noise is rebounding around on the inside of the guitar, it's actually building on the other sounds that it hits, getting louder and louder. Now I want you to imagine the world if all sound energy just all of a sudden
What does this TV, my shadow,
these light bulbs,
these strange glow worms, this concert footage, this busy freeway, our fire pit,
the sun,
and you,
who, me?
Yes, even you have in common. Next energy, light energy, right there. Without light energy, we wouldn't be able to see anything. Light energy comes from either the one natural source we have, our sun, or it comes from man-made objects such as light bulbs, night lights, flashlights, the light on my phone, for example, right? All of those produce light energy, which allow us to see whatever it is that it's shining on. Light comes from the sun in rays. In fact, we can see some of those rays coming off the sun right here. Now, those rays are full of billions, trillions, quadrillions of different colors, most of which, in fact, 90% of the colors that come from the sun cannot be seen by the human eye. But when those rays shine upon things, such as the grass, it allows us to see the grass. Without the light shining from the sun, none of this would be visible to us. Everything would be completely dark.
How does light energy help us see things? Wow! Grass!
Light comes to the earth from the sun in waves.
Remember the example of our sound waves? Light waves travel much, much faster.
Imagine a world devoid of light. Not only is it possible to live without the experience of light energy, which would be blindness, but it's possible to thrive, and many people have. Actually works as it comes out of the sun or whatever source it has in waves, and then it hits matter and then reflects back into our eyes. And that's actually all we're seeing, is the reflecting light hitting the matter and coming back at us. We're not actually seeing the matter, we're seeing the light reflecting off of the matter.
What is thermal energy and how do we
Thermal energy is energy that either creates or is created by heat. As something gets heated up, the molecules inside of it
begin to move faster and faster and faster and faster. And as they move faster, the temperature in that matter begins to rise. And that is thermal energy.
Den blecken Himmel fragst du dann, warum man sie nicht sehen kann.
Erst wenn die Wolken schlafen gehen, kann man uns am Himmel.
How are each of these energies useful in our everyday lives?
We harness the power of wind and water, the movement of those two elements, to move generators inside of dams and to move windmills. The mechanical energy with which allows us to produce power that we use to power our schools, our homes, and our businesses.
We use solar panels to collect the light energy from the sun to help us power our homes too.
Geothermal power plants harness the power of thermal energy to create power.
Without mechanical energy, the entire world would just simply stand still. Without sound energy, we wouldn't hear anything that goes on around us.
Without light energy, we wouldn't be able to see anything. Everything would be completely black.
And without thermal energy, there could be no life anywhere in the entire universe.
So how are each of these forms of energy useful in your everyday life? I bet if you really thought hard about it, you'd find that you use each of them far more than you realize.